Please, my dear Lord, have mercy and forgive me. Open your mouth and ask for mercy. Mercy from the Lord. Mercy from the King of Kings. Mercy from the Lord. Mercy from the Lord. Mercy. Mercy. The mercy of God. The mercy of God. Let's open our mouth and ask for the mercy of God. The mercy of the Holy Spirit. The mercy of the living God. Oh Lord, open your mouth and ask for mercy. Open your mouth and ask for mercy. Open your mouth and ask for the mercy of the Lord. There is a mercy that God uses to bless his own children, to save his own children. Let's ask for the mercy of God. Let's ask for the mercy of the Lord. Open your mouth and ask for the mercy of God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Glory be to your holy name. Thank you, precious God. We worship your name. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let's open our mouth and ask God and say, Father, please arise for me today. In my mighty way, in a glorious way, my Father, my God, please arise for me today. Let your name alone be glorified. Oh Lord, arise for me in a mighty way. Arise for me in a glorious way. Arise for me, my Father, my God. Arise for me in every way. Arise for my wife. Arise for my husband. Arise for my children. Arise for me in a glorious way. Please, Father, please, Daddy, arise for me. In a mighty way, please arise for me. In a glorious way, please arise for me. Arise for my children. Arise for my wife. Arise for my husband. Arise for the church of God. Arise for me, my Father. Please, my dear Lord, arise for me. Ancient of this, please arise. Arise for me. Lady of the valley, please arise for me. Rose of Sharon, please arise for me. Open your mouth and ask God, please arise for me. The Bible says, let God arise, let his enemies be scattered. Let those that hate him flee from me. Please, my Father, arise for me, O Lord. Arise for me, O Lord. Arise for me, O Lord. Please, my dear Lord, please arise for me. Arise for me, my Father, my God. Arise for me, my Father. Arise for me, King of Glory. Ancient of this, please arise for me. Lily of the valley, please arise for me. Oh Lord, my Father, arise for me, my Father, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Please, my Father, my God, arise for me, my Father. Arise for me in a new that in a new way, in a dimension that will surprise me. Please, my Father, arise for me, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's open our mouth and pray today. I say, Father, this evening, answer my prayer by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Please, this evening, please, my dear Lord, answer my prayer by fire. This evening, my Father, my God, I want to answer my prayer, oh Lord. Please answer my prayer by fire, my Father, my God, in a new way, in a dimension, oh Lord, that will surprise me, my Father. Please answer my prayer, oh Lord. Answer my prayer by Father. Answer my supplication. Answer my asking from you. Please let there be answers to me, my Father. Let your name be glorified. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
Brethren, we want to pray to the Almighty God. Genesis chapter 10. Genesis chapter 10, verse 9. Genesis 10, verse 9. Quickly, if you are there, you can read for us. The Lord bless you. Genesis chapter 10, verse 9. Thank you, Father. The Bible says, he was a mighty hunter. Let's start the reading from verse 7, please. From verse 7. Genesis 10, from verse 7. And the sons of Cush, Seba, and Avila, and Seba, and Rama, and Sabtecha, and the son of Rama, Sheba and Diga. Verse 8 says, and Cush begot Nimrod. He begot to be a mighty one in the earth. That is to say, Cush begot to be a mighty one in the earth. And verse 9 said, and he was a mighty hunter before the Lord. Wherefore it is said, even as Nimrod, the mighty hunter before the Lord. Praise the Lord. We are talking about the Almighty God. Here is an example of a man that is called mighty. In his own field, as an hunter, he happens to be a mighty man. He's a great man when it comes to hunting. He can hunt anything huntable. Because of time, Judges chapter 5. Judges 5, 25, 23. Judges 5, 23. What does the Bible say? The Bible made us understand. In the book of Judges chapter 5, verse 20, it says, "Cause ye merrows, said the angel of the Lord, cause ye bitterly the inhabitants thereof, because they came not to the help of the Lord, to the help of the Lord against the mighty." Here we see where God was causing Meros. God caused Meros, said the angel of the Lord. In fact, there was a repetition of it. He said, bitterly Meros was caused. And he gave the reason. He said the reason was that the inhabitant of Meros never came out to come and help the Lord, even to help the Lord against the mighty. That is to say, the mighty rose against the children of Israel. But then, Meros could not come out to come and help them. I am telling you how powerful mighty people can be. I don't know who is that mighty man or mighty woman or mighty people over your life. I don't know that thing that is so mighty against you. I am here to tell you about somebody that is mightier than the mightiest. I don't know the situation that has suppressed you down. I don't know the mighty that have been winning the battle over your life. I don't know that thing that every time when you say something is mighty, something that has strength, not something that has power, something that can succeed at any time. But I bring you good news this evening. That is the one that is mightier than that one that is mighty. He is mightier than the mightiest. No matter how the mighty are powerful, there is one that his power supersedes their own power to no extent. Therefore, I decree to somebody who can say amen, in the name that above every other name, the Almighty God power will be exercised to the mighty over your life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In the book of 2 Samuel chapter 1 verse 19, 2 Samuel chapter 1 verse 19, the Bible says, "The beauty of Israel is slain upon thy high places. How are the mighty fallen?" I am here to tell somebody, the mighty people, the mighty power, the mighty strength in your life, they are about to fall in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible says, "How are the mighty fallen? The people that call themselves so powerful, the people that call themselves so strong, the people that think that they own the world, they own the economy, they own the society, they are the men of the order of the day." The Bible says, "How, come and look at how they are falling. They fall by the power of the Lord. They fall by the sword of the Almighty God. They fall by the hands of the Lord." Therefore, I declare and I decree, the mighty, those ones that are manifesting their power over you, they will fall tonight over your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. 2 Samuel 23, verse 8. 2 Samuel chapter 23, verse 8. The Bible says, 2 Samuel 23, verse 8. The Bible recorded the mighty men whom David had, the chief captain, these be the names of the mighty men whom David had, the Tachmonite that sat in the teeth, chief among the captains, the same was Adino the Emrite. He lit up his spear against 800 whom he slew at one time. Praise God.
Amen.
The mighty man whom David had, the chief captain of that mighty man, the one that is even the captain of the mighty people, his name is called Adino. He killed 800 people at once with a spear in his hand. In fact, I begin to imagine, did the hand of this man never weary? He hold a spear in his hand and he slaughtered 800 people in a battle. I pray to somebody in the name of the Lord, no matter how powerful the mighty is over your life, tonight, my God, we disgrace them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But brethren, can you imagine a man called this Mr. Dino destroying, he happened to be the captain of the mighty men of David. Men of war, renowned people of war. men that are notable for what they have won. But brethren, do you know? These men died. No matter how many battles they have won, no matter how many places how many countries, cities they have won, all of them will be no more one day. But there is one that with power will exist. There is one that will never die till eternity. In fact, it's not limited by time. That's why we call him the Ancient of Days. He is the Almighty. All the mighty, they bow before him because that's why they call him the All. All means all. Everything means all. So when you collect all the powers of all the mighty, we see some people that are mighty in their own speed. Some mighty in the place of in their hunting work as an hunter. Genesis 10 verse 9, as we said. Some are mighty in the place of when they fight battle. Some they are mighty in their own field. But we are talking about the one that is the Almighty. Some are mighty in doing evil, performing evil. Some believe they have power to do anything that they want. But we say we have serving a God that has the power for all to do all. Therefore, that Almighty God, we visit you tonight as you pray in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So he's the one that's have all. Revelation chapter 1 verse 8. The book of Revelation chapter 1 verse 8. The Bible says, Revelation chapter 1 verse 8. Thank you, Father. Revelation 1 verse 8. The Bible says, I am Alpha and Omega. I am the beginning. I am the ending. Seeth the Lord. Which is, which was, and which is to come. The Almighty. The Almighty. God was giving a brief briefing of himself. He was telling us, I am the Alpha and the Omega. I am the one that was in the beginning. So I create your starting. But nobody create my starting. I create it and I put a limit and ending to it. Thank you, Father. I put an ending to it. Number one. Number two, he said, I am the one that is. Presently, I am. I am the one that was. Even before you are born, I have been. I am the one that you are still expecting. What a mighty God. He said, this is a mystery that you might not be able to understand. And that's why he called himself the Almighty. He owns every might. He is the one that can do all the impossible. For with God, the Bible said, nothing shall be impossible. Luke chapter 1 verse 37. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He is the only God that can cure the incurable. He is the only God that showing mighty things and performing mighty things. He is the God that has no limitation. There is no impossibility in his dictionary, brethren. Luke 1:37, for with God, nothing shall be impossible. I have seen God performing wonders beyond imagination. I have seen a woman without womb, God giving them birth. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
John chapter 11, so that we can go to God in prayer because of time. John chapter 11, verse 39 to 44. John 11, 39 to 44. It's about the story of the man called Lazarus. They went to go and tell, they told Jesus, Jesus, your friend that loved the sickness that hook him down has killed him. He waited 34 days. He told the brethren, he said, let us go and wake him up. And he was telling them again, he said, that man is dead, but we will wake him up. Praise God. He alighted when he arrived. He told them, Mary told him, say, your friend is dead. I didn't mean you are here, you could have, miracle will have happened. And Jesus was telling them, he's going to wake up. Yes, we know on the resurrection that we believe in your preaching. Yes, this guy will raise up, will rise again. So the resurrection starts that time. He said, take me to where you guys bury him. And he told them, roll away the stone. They roll away the stone. He called his name, Lazarus, come forth. That same hour, that same time, Lazarus heard the voice of the Almighty. It came out. The power, the mighty power that was holding him, that which is dead, could not stop him again. Therefore, I cry to God because of somebody. Any power holding you down today, they will release you by the hand of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Can I hear somebody say better? Amen.
Amen.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want hallelujah. To go to God in prayer because of our time. Let's ask God and bless the name of the Lord. Father, thank you for this hour. Thank you for this evening. You are the Almighty God. Let's give you the glory. Let's give him the honor. Let's adore his holy name. For he is the Almighty God. Let's exalt his holy name. Let's lift his name so high. Let's lift his name so high. For there is none like him. There is none like him. There is none like him. He has all the power to do the impossible. He is in the possession of all power to do the. Let's give him worship. Let's give him worship. Thank you, blessed God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
Amen. I want us to pray to God. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ,
Father, in the name of Jesus
everything
Christ.
That stands as impossibility before me, everything that stands as if it's a war, everything that stands as if I don't even know how to go, everything that put the standstill, a full stop for me, oh Lord, tonight, oh Lord, Father, roll those things out of me. Jesus knew that without the stone being rolled out, even if Lazarus woke up there, there was no way he can come out. That was the reason why he first addressed the issue of the stone. He said the stone should be rolled away. I want you to address any stone that you cannot see. Any stone you can. People that were there were not seeing the difficulties of the stone. But you have to command them and say, this is the thing you have to do for us. Roll away the stone. I want you to pray to God. Which stone? Which everlasting stone have been put against me? Which stone that I cannot see but is standing against me? Which stone is that don't want him to go ahead? Let's open the mouth and begin to pray. Which is a problem that stands as a stone? Father, I cry to you this hour. Roll them away, O Lord. Roll them away, oh Lord. Jesus told them, roll away the stone. I want you to begin to cry to God. I rolled them away. Every stone blocking me from going ahead, every stone blocking me from moving ahead, every stone standing against me, my Father, my God, tonight, oh Lord, I roll them up. I roll them up from every angle, from every area of my life, over my wife, my children. I roll them up. You stone from anywhere. You stone, no matter where you are coming from, no matter where you are. Rakatoka yadia pro. I roll you away. I command you are rolled away. You are rolled away. You are rolled away. You are rolled away. Every stone from everywhere you are coming from, everywhere they have used you to. I roll you away in the name of Jesus Christ. Rakoto Koria Gadabos, Maliatoka Ragataba. Let's cry to God. That stone is not from God. That's the reason why Jesus said, let them roll them away. You people that put this stone, come and take it off. Oh Lord, you have to cry to God. Every stone of problem, every stone of stagnancy, every stone of no go area. Oh Lord, every stone that does not want you to go ahead in every area. Let's cry to God. Every stone that wants to waste your time. Father, roll them away. Anything that represents stone in my life, my Father, I pray. Every stone blocking my womb, every stone blocking my breathing, every stone that does not want me to have my joy tonight, oh Lord. Every stone that is putting a stop to me, oh Lord, my Father, tonight, oh Lord, that he roll them away. I command those stones to be rolled away. Every stone in my education, every stone in everything I do, my Father, everything in the thing that I lay my hands upon, I command you to be rolled away. I command you to be rolled away. Oh Lord, roll them away. I command them to be rolled away by the anointing of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. Roll away, be rolled away by fire tonight, oh Lord, tonight. Every stone over my document, over my passport, over everything that concerns you. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Over my work, my Father, over my marital status, my Father, roll them away. Over my children, over my wife, my husband, over the church of God, over this order, I command them to be rolled away in the name of Jesus Christ. I command them to be rolled away. Be rolled away. Be rolled away. Tonight is the night, my Father. Be rolled away. Be rolled away. Let the mercy. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
I have two more prayer points for you quickly. I want you to pray to God and say, mercy is what located Lazarus. Mercy will locate somebody today in the name of Jesus Christ. I want to cry to God and say, mercy of the Lord. Mercy located a man who has died for 4 days, dead for 4 days, and mercy made him to wake up. Even among the dead, you want to cry to God tonight and say, Father, no matter where I am, mercy locate me. Locate me for miracle. Locate me for signs. Locate me for wonders. Mercy locate me. Oh Lord, no matter where they have put me, where the world have put me, let mercy locate me. I cry for mercy tonight. Open your mouth and cry for mercy. Mercy of the Lord. Mercy of the Lord. Mercy is what I need. Somebody need mercy here. It's not by power nor by mind, but by the mercy of the Lord. You need mercy, my Father. I need your mercy, my Lord. Somebody let a brother ask for mercy. Let a sister ask for mercy. Let the church ask for mercy. I need your mercy. My wife need your mercy. My husband need your mercy. My children need your mercy. I need your mercy concerning my work. I need your mercy concerning my marriage. I need your mercy concerning. I don't know what we are waiting. We are looking unto God to do in your life. You need mercy for the answer. I need mercy, oh Lord. I need mercy, oh Lord. Let somebody cry for mercy. Let somebody cry for mercy. Mama katoka reakota kayaraba. I need mercy, my Father, to be able to live in this old world. I need mercy to be able to get miracle, my Father. It's only by your mercy, please, my Father. Let your mercy be extended to me over my physical life, financial life, spiritual life, in every area. Mercy, oh Lord. Mercy, oh Lord. Mercy, oh Lord. The Bible says, "I will have mercy on who I will have mercy of." Father, let that mercy locate me. Let it be me, my Father. Let it be me, my Lord. Ancient of me, let it be me. My Father, my God, let it be me. Let that mercy be me. Let that mercy be me. I have no power of my own. I have no strength of my own. Let that mercy be me, oh Lord. Let that mercy be me, my Father. Rakoto kolia toka ya dabosh. Malia do de kelia prakaba. Let mercy deliver me, oh Lord. Let mercy set me free. Let mercy locate me, oh Lord, in the name of the Lord. Thank you, my Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Lastly, I don't know what you want from God. I want you to ask from God in 1 minute. Go ahead and ask from him. I don't know what you want God to do in your life. I don't know the miracle you are expecting or you are asking God to do. I don't know how you want God to visit you. It might be difficult for man, but let me tell you, brethren, it's a simple thing for God. Please go ahead and ask from God. I trust God. The Lord that visited that man called Lazarus, he can visit you in a miraculous way. He can take, oh my God, God is so great that he can do break protocol because of you. Please ask him, ask from the Lord this hour. God is, I have received a lot of testimony concerning this altar. If he has done it in the life of others, he can also do it in your life. Come and go ahead and begin to cry to God. I cry to God concerning that thing you are asking God to do. He is ready to do it. That is a manifestation coming to the life of somebody this very month. Maria to Eria Dagaba. Let the broker satayandaba. Le prakota kayanda kalaba. Regede broker satoyandakaba. Le dadia broker sataba. Thank you, my Father. Bless the name of the Lord. Let's bring that prayer to close. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Brethren, as I close, no matter how we pray, your salvation matters so much to God. Except you are born again, the kingdom of God, there is no way. Surrender your life to Jesus Christ. Give your life to him totally. And come and see all your prayer. How it will be. And before you mention one prayer point, God has given you answers. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that answers have come to your prayer points in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Therefore, don't take salvation for joke. It is so much important. And I pray in the name of the Lord, testimony will be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
I will see you the same time tomorrow. As we go ahead, I'm trusting the Lord that my God will answer by fire in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Don't forget the program on Sunday, immediately after the service. It is possible. The theme for this month says, lift your head, O ye gates. Hallelujah. I'm praying in the Lord, in the name of the Lord. Every gate will be lifted up by the special grace of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord bless you really good. He will cause his face to shine upon you. His oil will never dry over your life. And I'm praying in the name of the Lord, before we see or hear from each other, testimony is your portion in Jesus' name. Go and bring your testimony. It is well. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we are prayed.
Amen.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God bless you mightily. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.